ओके हेलो ओके सो वी स्टार्ट विद द सेशन। एम ऑडिबल? या होप सो। यस So welcome back. So we are conducting one guest session sponsored by AICT Prerna Center for SCST students at Vidya Pratishthan Kamalnayan Bajaj Institute of Engineering and Technology Baramati. This session is for network theory, and today we will look for two port network. So far we have completed elements, the characteristics, different methods. Now we'll go for two port network, and simultaneously we'll go for the different previous year gate questions. Okay, so let us begin with today's topic, that is two port network. Yes. It is visible to all of you. Let me just give me 1 second. Okay. Yes. Yes. So today we'll start with the first topic, that is two port network, and along with that we'll solve some numerical which will be related to your two port network. Okay. So why there is need of this network? So we'll begin with the general scenario, and then we'll start with the in detail depth of your network. Okay, see what happened in general way. It is very easy to analyze any electrical network. Okay, so the network we have looked so far, okay, I think you are now capable to analyze the any electrical network. And we are looking for the network theory. So definitely we are reducing the complexity of the network, and accordingly we are following different methods. One of them, two-port network is one of them. Okay, and today we'll look for the two-port network and its network function along with some example. So when we are going to analyze the electrical network, if it is represented in terms of model, now what do you mean by model? Model is the one which will gives you relation between input and output network. Means what? Suppose model is the one which will gives the relation between input table and output table. Suppose this is my one end, this is a input side, this one is the output one. Now this relation between the input and output table variable is nothing but your model, correct? And for these we can use certain network which is nothing but a two-port network, correct? So as from this name you can able to understand, two-port network, definitely it should have how many number of ports? This is one and this is two. That's why it is called as two-port network. Single port network, we can say one port network is also available, but two-port network is having one at the input side, one at the other side. So it's forming a two-port network, among which one port is used as, so this is one port and this is second port. So this one port will act as a input port and other will be used as output ports, correct? So by which sometimes we write it as port 1 and port 2 respectively. Okay, suppose this is my two port network. So definitely if I'm saying two port network, so it should represent in terms of two parameters. So this is one which is acts in the input one and this is in the output one. So what will the case in one port network? What will the case for the one port network? See, one port network is the one, this part we will skip and we will consider only this one, correct? We'll consider only this part. So this one port network is a two terminal network. This is a two terminal network through which one term current will enters, current will enters into the node, into the network from one terminal and leaves through the another terminal. But in this two port network, what is happening? We are applying certain voltage, so across the both the terminal, which will act as a one port, and from these two, we are another inserting another terminal, that is another port. But for single port, we are having, I will show you diagram if it is there, just, okay. See, we will consider here itself. So the highlighted section is nothing but a diagram for two terminal, one port network. Okay. So the upper terminal, we can say upper terminal and the lower terminal will form one network, and in this case we will call it as a single port network, which is similar to two port network. A pair of, we can say a pair of two terminal in electrical network in which current will enter through one terminal and it will leave through another terminal of each port, so it is forming a two port network. Likewise here, this is one port pair, terminal pair, and this is another pair of another terminal which is called as a port. Okay, now what they have seen, what they have given, see, what do you mean by port? So port is basically a pair of terminal at which an electrical signal may enter or leave a network is called a port. Likewise this one, in this scenario the electrical signal fed to the network and it can be leave from another terminal, so it is called as a network, correct? So this is the definition of a network, of a port which is connected to the network, so that is called as two port network. Now we are looking for the two port network which is consisting of two pair of terminal, correct? Now the terminal or the port is required. Why is the necessity of this terminal? See, without this terminal we cannot connect our input and we cannot connect our parameter. So for the excitation of the network, input feeding is important, correct? And this input will get connected to my the network in terms of port, correct? So the terminal or the port is required for connecting input excitation to the network, and this is also called as two port network. Suppose one is from the input one, another is from the load one, so these are forming two port network, correct? In same way, if a network having only one port, that is called as a one port network, and a network having two port, so it is called as two port network. So this is the basic difference. If it consists only one, so this is nothing but a one port network. If it is considered like this one, so it is a two port network. That's it. There is no any difference, correct? Now, just 12 seconds, what happened? This is okay. Yeah. So the question is, how we will represent it? That is the question. How we can represent this terminal or the pair of terminal for the network, because when you are calculating the parameter, so basically we need to choose two variable, whether it is independent or dependent. We will come to it later. First we will start with the two port network. Okay, so what they have given, in if V1 and I1, if V1 and I1 are my the port variable, what we have studied, what we have learned, this is my one port, correct? So V1 and I1, these are my port variable. Similarly, for the port 2, which will be my port variable for the output side, output port, one is acts as an input port, so other will definitely, it will act as a output port, correct? So variable for the output port will be, it will be V1, V2 and I2. Correct. So if I'm consisting two port network, so how many variables we have? We have total four variables, correct? Which one? V1, V2, I1 and I2. So there are total four variable, V1, V2, I1 and I2, correct, in two port network. If I'm considering only the one network, so either having a V1, I1 or I1 and return path, correct? So out of these, we can choose two variable as independent one and other two variable as a dependent one, correct? How many variable we have? We have total four variable, V1, V2, I1, I2, so in a, which is for two port network. Keep in mind, we are learning for the two port network, correct? Now if we want to choose, so we can choose any two variable as independent and another two variable as a dependent variable. Okay, so why there is need, what is the importance of this? So we'll get six possible pair of equation, and this equation, whatever the equation we will obtain, it will represent in terms of dependent variable and in terms of independent variable, correct? And the coefficient of this independent and dependent variable is nothing but your parameter. Okay, so each pair of equation will give us a set of four parameter. Now we are looking for two port network parameter. So the parameter is the one. What do you mean by parameter? Parameter of this two port network, we will call it as Z parameter, एडमिटेंस पैरामीटर, टी पैरामीटर, एच पैरामीटर, जी पैरामीटर. ओके, सो वील गो इन टू दिस वन बाय वन, वील गो इन टू दिस वन बाय वन. बिफोर दैट लेट अस अंडरस्टूड इन डेप्थ ऑफ टू पोर्ट नेटवर्क. करेक्ट. सो वॉट वी हैव ऑब्टेन सो फार, वी हैव ऑब्टेन फोर वेरिएबल, दैट इज वी वन, वी टू, आई वन एंड आई टू. करेक्ट. यस. नाउ so we have two port network. Now we'll start the analysis. So before start the analysis, they are saying to begin the analysis with this two port network, it is necessary to assume certain parameter. So we have total two parameter need to in consideration. That is first one, what they are saying, let us study. The network inside the box is assumed to consist only the linear element. So whatever the network which is present inside this two port network, this is box is there, so this is present in this two port network, it consists only the linear element. The linear element was what? Linear element is what? So according to the output, according to the input, your output should get change, that is linear one. If it is not producing output according to the input, so definitely what we will say, it is a non-linear. So the assumption, so what do you mean by first assumption? If I want to study this two port network, if I want to utilize this two port network by my application, my first assumption, it should be linear element. Correct. Also, the network may consist of dependent source, but independent source are not allowed. So the first assumption is it should be linear one. What should be linear one? The network which is present, it should be linear one, and network which is present, it should be linear one, and it should consist of dependent sources. Sorry, it should consist of dependent sources, but not allowed your independent sources. Correct. That is the most first assumption for designing two port network. Okay, let us understood next one. What do you mean by second port? If the network consists of energy storing element, so these are talking about the active element, sorry, a passive element such as inductor, capacitor, then initial condition on them is assumed to be zero. Correct. This is another scenario. What they are saying, if the network is consisting energy storage device, so first these two conditions are necessary while designing any two port network. So if the network consists of energy storing element such as inductor, capacitor, why resistor has not involved here? Because the resistor is dissipates energy. It's not resistor never stores energy. Correct. So that's why they are saying if we need to assume that first one, it should not independent sources, there should not be any independent sources, and it should consist of only linear element. And in the next scenario they are saying it should consist of only which one? Passive element. Among them, it should consist only capacitor and inductor, and we have to assume it's at zero initial condition. Correct. This is the foremost scenario. Now, yes, so this is about the two port network. So two port network, if want to summarize in a short, after that we'll go for the types of Z parameter, two port parameter. So two port network is what? It's an electrical network or the circuit or a device with two pair of terminal to connect to external circuit. Correct. So with the help of this two port network, we will connect to the external circuit. So that's why we are using this two-port network. Now we will look for what are the two-port network parameter. So for the two-port network, generally we have Z parameter, Y parameter, T parameter, H parameter, G parameter. So among them, we will look for the four most important parameter. Yes. Now this two-port network, the general scenario for the gate point of view, this is nothing but, as we know, Thevenin's equivalent. So you know about the Thevenin's equivalent, which will permit us for a simple linear network, correct? And this two-port network, which require how many terminal pair? Two terminal pair. So total four terminal. So among these two voltage and the two current, will generally take in consideration independently. Okay, so we can say this is a part of your extension of your Thevenin's one. Another one for key point for the gate point of view, two-port network is always to be said to be symmetrical one. Okay, so you in this example, in the not example, in this, yes, here you can observe a two-port network is always said to be symmetrical one if the input and output ports can be interchanged without alternating the port voltage and current. So network will having inverse of it. Okay, so whatever the ports which is present at the input side acts as the input terminal port, same will act as a output terminal port, correct? So it is a two-port network. So for two-port network, we'll go for symmetry, correct? Now the question is, two-port network is there, but what is the application of this two-port network? So if you know the application, then it will be very easy to understand for the particular scenario. So we are using this mostly for the model of voltage and current characteristics of complex electrical network. So when there is a complex electrical network, or when a single phase transformer is an ideal example of this two-port network. Single phase transformer, correct? One is the primary side, one other is the secondary side. So this is a look like as a single phase transformer is nothing but your two-port network. Okay, so primary winding is there, secondary winding is there, input voltage are there, V1, V2, so V1, I1. For the secondary side, we are having V2, I2, and among them we are having turns ratio. In same way, that is nothing but representation of your two-port network. So such type of complex electrical networks are there. So we use two-port network, correct? Yes. Now we will begin with the, yes. So as I said, this is two-port network is nothing but what? It's nothing but symmetrical network. So what about the unsymmetrical network? What about the unsymmetrical network? So unsymmetrical network, what will happen? See, I'll let you know. This is my input one. And for the single input, if there are multiple, for single incoming or single input port, if there are multiple outgoing or multiple output port, so we will say it's a unsymmetrical network. Okay, so at that time it's a unsymmetrical network. Okay, so this is how we can identify a symmetric one and the asymmetrical one, correct? Now we will move further. So right now we have just identified the use, the application, the some gate point of view scenario about the two port network. I'll again repeat the assumptions you should taken into consideration. For 1 mark it has been asked for two-port network, dependent sources are used or independent sources are used, which one? So we are blocking independent sources and we are allowing only the dependent sources along with the linear element. If I'm using it for the two-port network, so only it consists of only inductor and capacitor and the at zero initial condition, correct? Yes. So assuming this variable as input and output port, we are able to find out certain possible ways of two-port network. Okay,
as we discussed, there are total six possible ways for selecting the independent variable out of four variables. Correct? So which are they? Which are they? So we are having impedance, we are having admittance, we are having hybrid, we are having inverse hybrid, that is denoted by G, we are having transmission and inverse transmission. So inverse transmission is T dash. Correct? Which are the two ports network parameters are available? So one is Z parameter, that is your impedance, Y parameter, that is your admittance, then we are having transmission parameter, that is T, inverse transmission, that is T dash, hybrid parameter, that is H, and inverse hybrid, that is G. Correct? These parameter what we have. So let us start with the first one, that is Z parameter. Yes. Yes. What they have given? What they have given? We have started with the first one, that is Z parameter. So let us understood what you mean by Z parameter. Yes. So through this Z parameter, we will get the set of two equations by considering what we have considered. What we have considered? We have considered V1 and V2 as dependent variable and I1 and I2 as an independent variable. As at the start of this session, what we have come across, for this two port arrangement or two port network arrangement, we need to consider dependent variable as an independent variable. So the left side, at the left side, what variable I have used, V1 and V2. So these are the dependent variable, and this dependent variable we will write equation. Okay, so what is the equation for the Z parameter? V is equal to function of I1 and I2, and for V2 we have the I1 comma I2. So that is nothing but V1 is equal to Z, Y, Z, because we are considering the impedance. We are calculating two port network. We are designing the two port network for Z parameter. Correct? So the coefficient of this impedance independent variable are independent variable here, as I just said, V1, V2 are the dependent variable, then I1, I2 will be it should be independent variable. So it means that we need to write the equation for I1 and I2, and that is nothing but your, it should represent as Z parameter. So the coefficient of independent variable, that is your I1 and I2, are nothing but your Z parameter. So we will write the equation, we will modify the equation 1 and 2 as V1 is equal to Z11 I1, Z12 I2, V2 is equal to Z21 I1, Z22 I2. Okay, can anyone say, tell me, same kind of equation we have obtained for the power system? Okay, remember the thing about the ABCD parameter, same thing, correct? This is a replica of your transmission line. But for the transmission parameter, we have another two port network parameter, that is your T parameter. Okay, T parameter is for the transmission one, and T dash is for the inverse transmission, or correct? So this Z parameter from this equation 3 and 4, what we will able to write? What we will able to write? We can write the equation for matrix. So how the matrix will form? How matrix will form? From the equation number 3 and 4, so we will form the matrix as V1, V2 is equal to Z11, Z12, Z21, Z22, and I1 and I2. So for combined equation, we will rewrite as V is equal to Z into I. Now we will apply certain condition. This is what we need to check. Suppose first condition. Okay. First condition. If I2 is equal to 0, when I2 will be 0. It means what? What we have considered? I1 and I2 are my independent variable, and V1 and V2 are my dependent variable. So if I2 is 0, means what? Just consider here, I2 is present at which point? At this output side, correct? So when I2 is equal to 0, when I2 is equal to 0, my port should be open circuited, correct? So at this condition, my port should be open circuited. So I will put I2 is equal to 0 in equation above equation, and we will get the value of V1 as so this is the equation. Okay, so V1, if you put the value of I2 is equal to 0, so this whole term will become 0. So V1 is equal to Z11 into I1. So what we need to calculate? We are expected to calculate the value of Z11, that is Z first parameter, that is V1 upon I1. Correct? Yes. Now we will put same value. We will put same value of I2 in equation 4. So what we will get? We will get the parameter of Z21. Yes or no? Yes, we will get the value of Z21. Yes. Kindly let me know what is the value of Z21. The value of Z21. Yes. Simple. What we have done for first network, for first steps, I2 is equal to 0. So we have put I2 is equal to 0 in equation number 3 and 4. So now, if we put this same value of I2 in equation number 4, what will the value of Z21? You can drop in chat box, no doubt. Yeah. Yes. Okay. So Z21, we will get modify one as. How much? If you put the value of I2 is equal to 0, we will get the value of Z21 as V2 by I1. Correct? So Z1 is called as open circuit driving point, and Z21 is called as forward transfer impedance. This is what they ask in your exam. Z11 is called as, this is, you can note down this one. Z11 is called as open circuit driving point input impedance, and Z21 is called as open circuit forward transfer impedance. Correct. In same way, we will make this calculation for remaining one. What we have calculated? We have calculated two Z parameter. Let us recap the same one for I1 is equal to 0. Okay, so when I'll say I1 is equal to 0, it means that my input terminal is open circuited. Yes, so put the values of I1 is equal to 0 and let me know the values of this. I'll scroll it down. Let me know the value of the remaining Z parameter. You can drop in chat box. Yes, how much? Let me know the value. What you have to do? You have to put the I1 is equal to 0 in equation.
Yes. So what will happen? If you put value of I1 is equal to 0, so V1 will modify this equation. V1 is equal to Z12 into I2, and from that we will obtain Z12. If we put the value of I1 is equal to 0, so V2 is equal to Z22 into I2. Okay, so we'll obtain the same equation as we have derived earlier. Okay, now you can observe for Z12 it's called as open circuit reverse transfer impedance, and Z22 is called as open circuit driving point output impedance. So what is the significance difference? What will be the significant difference? Z11 and Z22 are the driving point impedance, but this is at the input port, so it is represented as input, here represented output. Z21 and Z12 are the open circuit transfer function, but it is a forward one, and at this it is a reverse one. Okay, this is the finding of Z parameter. What we obtain from this, we obtain Z parameter, that is Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22. Correct. So therefore, what we'll say, what will our conclusion? What will be our conclusion? Yes, from this equivalent network of two port network. Yes, this is what we have obtained from Z parameter. So this is Z parameter, which is nothing but an open circuit impedance parameter, which represents your value for the parameter in terms of impedance parameter. Because these all are simply the ratio of voltage and current, and unit of impedance parameter is nothing but your ohm. So what we have done, we calculate the two Z parameter by doing open the circuit of port 2. Similarly, we calculate other two Z parameter, Z12 and Z22, by doing opening circuit of port 1. Hence, the Z parameter are called as open circuit impedance parameter. Okay. For each process, we have opened that particular port. So for the first one, we open the left one, that is port 1. For the second step, we will open the port 2. So it is called as open circuit impedance parameter. And the diagram it is showing for the equivalent network for two port network in terms of Z parameter. Okay, this is the significant difference. Okay, now let us move further. Now we will calculate admittance parameter. Okay, same cases, but here I have, for the gate point of view, I have make it as short as possible. The first one was the lengthy one, or we can say precise one. Now for the impedance, for admittance hybrid, and for the transmission, I have derived a very short step which will get highlighted of each and every parameter, correct? So for Y parameter, or we can say admittance parameter, same things that we need to follow for this only. Now we are first we look for the admittance one. Okay, then you will tell me how we obtain the parameter for hybrid and transmission one. Correct? Yes. What they have given. See, we are looking for admittance parameter. So by following this set of these two equations, that is I1 is equal to function of V1 and V2, and I2 is equal to function of V1 comma V2, we will get the set of two equation by considering variable I1, and here we will consider I1 and I2 as a dependent one and V1 and V2 as a independent one. Correct? So the coefficient of this independent variable, so here which are the independent variable, V1 and V2. So coefficient of this V1 and V2 are nothing but your admittance parameter. Correct? Now we will follow same equation procedure as we have done for Z parameter. Okay, just have a look and let me know how you will able to, are you able to calculate the Y parameter or not. Okay, just have a glance at this Y parameter model. Then we will move for hybrid and T parameter. Yes. Tell me.
previous. What were the steps? What will be the steps? Yes, same steps that what we have followed, we need to follow here. Yes, what step you have followed for the, we should follow for the y parameter? Yes, so which are the coefficient of this independent variable? So for this we have v1 and v2 as independent variable, and we will call it coefficient of this, we will call it as y parameter. So from this we will obtain two equation, that is I1 is equal to y11 v1 y12 v2, and I2 is equal to y21 v1 and y22 v2. So same thing, instead of current here we will put value of v2 is equal to 0, and we will calculate, for the short circuit. Okay, here we are keeping it as a short circuit. Okay, in last z parameter we are keeping it as a open circuit one, correct? So when we put the values of V2 is equal to 0, so port 2 will be short circuit 1, and same case we will repeat for V1 is equal to 0, so in that case short port 1 should be short circuit 1. So we'll, let us keep the value of V2 is equal to 0, so these terms will come 0, so we'll get the value of Y11. Yes, let me know the value of Y11. What is the value of Y11? Y11 will obtain when we will put the value of V2 is equal to 0. One more value we will obtain when we will put the value of V2 is equal to 0. So that is nothing but Y11 and Y21. We will put this value in above equation, that is nothing but your equation for dependent variable, which are nothing but your I1 and I2. Yes. You can drop in chat box, no doubt. Make it fast. Okay. Apart from that, when we will yes. I hope so you have obtained the value of V1 and keeping V1 is equal to 0 and V2 is equal to 0. So the value what we are obtaining, these are nothing but Y11 is equal to I1 by V1, Y12 is equal to I1 by V2, Y21 is nothing but I2 by V1, Y22 is nothing but I2 by V2. So we obtain the Y11 value when V2 is equal to 0. We obtain Y12 value when V1 is equal to 0. We will obtain Y21 when V2 is equal to 0 and Y22 when V1 is equal to 0. So, in this case, what we have done, we have keep it as a short circuit one, correct? We have keep it as a short circuit one. So, this is nothing but your short circuit admittance parameter, okay? These are nothing but your short circuit admittance parameter, which is called as admittance parameter or short circuit admittance parameter, correct? Because these are simply the ratio of your current and voltages. So unit of this parameter is nothing but your moho. Okay, unit will be moho because we are considering the admittance. So what we have done, we simply calculate the Y admittance parameter by doing short circuit of port 2. And similarly, we calculate the other two parameters, that is Y12 and 22, by doing short circuit of port 1. Hence, the y parameter, which is what we obtain, is called as short circuit admittance parameter. Okay, this is what we have obtained for the two port network. This is another port network, another parameter, that is admittance parameter. Correct. Now let us move for next one, that is nothing but your which one? Hybrid parameter. Okay, so the middle one, okay, diagram was remaining. Yes, this is the equivalent diagram. This one is the equivalent diagram for, this is the equivalent diagram for y parameter. Okay, just look into it. If you have any difficulty, please let me know. So what we have done, we have done the calculation for admittance and impedance parameter. Correct. Now we'll move for the next one, that is hybrid parameter. Okay, so first we'll learn this and then we'll come across the examples. So we have some examples to solve. Yes, such type of examples that we need to solve, but before that we need to cover all this. Yes, so this is nothing but we'll start with the next parameter, that is admittance parameter. Correct. Yes, so before proceeding further, just give me 1 second. So I have dropped this link in your chat box. Kindly click on it and fill the feedback form. So within 2 minutes, we'll resume our session. ओके Yes. So what we are so far? So now let us start with the hybrid parameter, and let us understood how we represent two port network in terms of hybrid parameter. Same methods we need to follow. Only the change will be okay. So here, as you know, for the impedance, we write a equation we have written as V1 and V2 was our dependent variable, and for admittance, I1 and I2 were our dependent variable. Here we are making combination of it. So that's why it is called as a hybrid one, correct? So V1 and voltage from input port and the current from the output port will consider as a dependent variable, and the current from the input terminal and the voltage from the output terminal will consider it as a independent variable. So obviously the coefficient of this independent variable, that is I1 and V2, are nothing but your hybrid parameter. Okay, so accordingly, now we need to write down equation for hybrid parameter. Okay, so this is nothing but equation for hybrid parameter, that is V1 is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2, and I1 is equal to V21 I1 and H22 V2. Okay, now same condition we need to follow, that is nothing but your which one? That is nothing but your, we have to keep here V2 as a 0, and we need to find out the H parameter, and then we need to keep I1 as a 0, and we need to find out remaining parameter. Okay, so follow the procedure and let me know the answer. Yes, what will the answer? What will the parameter? We are looking for the hybrid one. That is nothing but we will design this two port network on the basis of H parameter. Here we have considered the hybrid manner, like one from the input one and another one from the output side. Correct? Yes. So we'll obtain the value of V when we'll keep V2 is equal to 0. So H1 we will obtain as V1 upon I1, and when V2 is equal to 0, we'll obtain H21 as I2 upon I1. Well, how we will obtain? Just think on this V1 and V2, because we have taken mixed parameter. Okay, remaining procedure for the overall scenario will remain same. And if you compare, okay, one more step is remaining. Now we have to keep V1 and I2, I1 is equal to 0. Okay, so when I will keep I1 is equal to 0, so this terminal gets 0, and we have to obtain the equation for V1, I2 and this one. Okay. So yes, let me know the value for H12 and H22. It will easily obtain as compared to the above equation. Okay, so what we learned from this hybrid parameter? Why it is called a hybrid one? Okay, first let me know, is there in units for this hybrid parameter?
Okay, so for this hybrid parameter, they do not have any units because those parameters are dimensionless. One parameter is having ohm unit, other is having mho unit, so obviously it will get cancelled. What we obtain for the impedance unit here, unit was ohm for open circuit impedance. For the admittance, it was a short circuit impedance, unit was mho. And here we are making hybrid one, so one unit get cancelled with another, so it's a unitless quantity. This is asked in gate exam for 1 mark. Okay, yes. So here what we have done, we need only calculate the parameter, that is H11 and H21, by doing short circuit of port 2, that is output port. And we calculate, or other hand, we calculate the parameter H12 and H22 by open circuiting of O21. Correct? So in hybrid, in the way, at output terminal we short circuit it, and at the input terminal we open circuit it. So open circuit parameter, we will look into the Z parameter, and admittance we look for the short circuit one. So that's why it is called a Z admittance, and impedance combination is there, so it is called as hybrid one. Correct? So where we will utilize? So this hybrid parameter we will use in modeling of network. When there is a complex network is there, we will use this hybrid parameter. Correct? Now, next, and the important is nothing but your transmission parameter, T parameter, or we can say ABCD parameter. Okay, this is what we are obtained in our power system scenario. Correct? One is the sending end, another is the receiving end transmission line, and we are considering certain constant coefficient of this transmission line in terms of certain ABCD parameter. Okay, so here in terms of, we will represent this parameter in terms of ABCD. As in Z parameter, we represent in terms of alpha, English alphabet, that is Z. In Y parameter, we represent by Y. For hybrid, we represented by H. For transmission, instead of representing it by T, we are representing it by ABCD parameter. Okay, so we'll get the following set of value, that is V1 is equal to function of V2 and I2. For I1, we'll get the function of V2 and I1. So the equation for this will be, your V1 is equal to a V2 minus B into I2, and I1 is equal to CV2 minus B into I2. Correct? Same methodology we need to follow, that is keeping I2 is equal to 0, and we will find out the value for A and C. Then we will keep V2 is equal to 0, and we will find out the value for B and D. So find out the values and let me know in chat box whether values you have obtained. See, it is on the screen, but still you should have a practice, and it should be a quick one. I expecting answer in quick way. Yes, so what we are doing, we are just simply putting the values of I2 is equal to 0 and V2 is equal to 0. Yes, let me know the answer. Yes, the answer will be what we have keep A is equal to V1 by V2, B is equal to minus V1 by I2, C is equal to I1 by V2, and D is equal to
I1 divided by I2. And these are nothing but your transmission line parameter, or we can call it as ABCD parameter, or we can call this as T parameter. Okay, any one question might be asked. T parameter, if the output port is open circuited, then what will the parameter, or what will the coefficient for this transmission line parameter? So at that time you need to answer very correctly. So it is called as T parameter, it is called as a transmission parameter, it is also called as ABCD parameter. Just one second. Yes. So here there is a some complexity. If you just observe the parameter A and D, which doesn't have any units, but for parameter B and C, B will be having a unit of ohm, and parameter C, that is I by V, it should have units of mho, correct? And the parameter A is V1 by V2, so it will get cancelled. And also parameter D, it's I1 by I2, so it will get cancelled, correct? So what we have done so far, we have calculated the two parameter A and C by doing open circuit of output port, and we have calculated parameter B and D by doing short circuit of port 2. So this T parameter will obtain in terms of ABCD parameter, correct? So these are some parameter calculation of two port network, okay? And the inverse of this H is nothing but G parameter, and inverse of T is nothing but your transmission, inverse transmission, that is your T dash parameter, correct? So for your convenience, it is not useful, so we'll go for next topic, that is nothing but your, we are calculating the Z parameter in terms of remaining one. See, we have calculated the 4-1, that is, we have calculated the Z parameter, Y parameter, hybrid one, and ABCD parameter. Now we will look for how we will convert this complex network Z parameter in terms of admittance, in terms of hybrid, and in terms of ABCD parameter. In next scenario, we will come across the hybrid parameter in terms of in terms of Y parameter, in terms of Z, hybrid, and ABCD. In next scenario, we'll come across this one. So this goes on increasing by permutation combination of each parameter in terms of this. Okay. And based on that, we will solve a numerical on this. Okay. But first, we will solve a numerical, that what parameter that we have looked for, and then we will go for this. Correct? Yes, so write down the equation, write down the example. So in one example, I will cover all the scenario. So you'll able to understood how we calculate this one. Correct? Yes, I hope you have noted down the network. So what we have done so far, we have discussed the types of two-port network parameter. We have discussed the different types of two-port network parameter, that is your Z1, impedance, admittance, then hybrid, and the last one was transmission. Apart from that, we have two more, that is inverse of transmission parameter and the hybrid parameter, correct? So what will the pro, okay, yes, Now let us understand the example. What they have given. Okay, so this one example is nothing but a replica for all the parameters that what we have designed so far. See, what they have given. The question is to find, need to find Z, impedance parameter, Y, admittance parameter, H, hybrid parameter, and ABCD. Okay, sometimes they will call it as T parameter. Correct? So ABCD parameter of the network. And the network is like, so this will be my two-port network. So this is my input pair terminal. This will be my output pair terminal. Correct? Yes. Now they are asking for calculate, look into this network and calculate the parameter, all types of parameter for this particular network. Okay, so now let us focus on this. Yes. So what they have given? V1 is a voltage source. Okay, he will observe. V1 is a voltage source. V2 is another voltage source. These are the value of passive element. That is here only the resistance is present. So this is a value of resistor. Now we need to apply KVL. Okay, we can solve this using by KVL. No doubt we can solve this same example by using KCL also. Okay, so which law you need to apply, that depends on you. There is no any question mark, but whatever the easy, you can go for it. Okay, so today we will apply the KCL, KVL, and for next session we'll look for the KCL also. So any type of example they will ask, you will come to know how to solve it. See what they have given. This is my one loop, this is my second loop, this will be my third loop, and this is the what network that what we have. By applying the two-port network transmission parameter methodology, we need to find Z, Y, H, and ABCD. This is our finding. Correct? So let us start. What we have learned? At the start, we should have the equations. Okay, this is what we have looked in this. We should have equation for our finding. So same way, we'll sort it out. First we'll solve the numerical, then we'll look for the different steps. Okay, so to solve this, what will be the different steps that we need to follow? Okay, what we are doing, what's our aim? We are converting the one set of two port network parameter into the another set. So one set we have, that is this one, and we need to convert for the Z, Y, H, and ABCD. Correct? So first we will write down the equation of a two-port network in terms of desired parameter. So what the two-port network we have? We have V1. First we will apply the network for. We have the first equation. V1 is equal to 3 into I1 minus 2 into I3. That is for KVL is applying for loop 1. So if you consider this loop 1, you will get the value of, by KVL, you will come to know V1 is equal to what? V1 is equal to what? The 3-1. How I will calculate? See, I1 is flowing through 1 ohm resistor, so it is I1. I1 is flowing through 2 ohm resistor, so it is a 3I1. Correct? Minus this I3, is opposing to I1. And it is flowing through 2 ohm. So we will write at 2 ohm. I have made it easy. Correct? So first equation we will obtain is nothing but V1 is equal to 3I1 minus 2I3. Correct? That is nothing but your equation A. Or we can say, yes, here we can say it is A. Same, we will apply.
for loop 2. Okay, so you can write down here loop 1, loop 2, loop 3, correct? So for loop 2, what we need to obtain, we will apply same KVL and we will find out the value for V2, correct? So here V2, I'll say, okay, this is for middle one. The B equation is for this one, correct? So V2 is nothing but, it is current, let's just consider on the current directions, it is flowing in this way. So I2 plus I3, this I2 is coming through this 2 ohm, I3 is also entering through this 2 ohm. So I2 plus I3 into which one? 2 ohm resistance is equal to your V2, correct? So what we equation we obtain, that is V2 is equal to, so this total V2 for this particular loop, V2 is in nothing but what? 2 into I2 plus 2 into I3. Now you say, sir, why there is addition of the current? See the direction of current, the current is flowing in which way? Just look into the direction of current, correct? So it is I2 plus I3. It is showing I2 plus I3, that is we obtain second equation. Now one more loop is remaining, that is the middle one. Here there is no any source, so we will obtain the equation in terms of current, and the current will be your I2 and I3, and the I1 which is flowing to 2 ohm branch. So how will rewrite the equation? So we will start with the left side. 2 ohm resistance is there. So the loop for which we are considering the direction of current, we will take as the higher one, and my in difference with that, I1 we will consider as the lower one. So I3 minus I1 is flowing through 2 ohm resistance. So that is minus 2 into I3 minus I1. I'm talking about this one. Next, I will move for I3. So same I3 will flow through 1 ohm resistance, and I2, now this 2 ohm resistance. So here I3 and I2 are the in same direction. So I3 plus I2, and it's a minus I2, correct? So we will obtain this equation. Again, check it. Minus 2 into I3 minus I1, minus 3, and the next branch of branch that is having element 2 ohm resistance. So 2 minus 2 into I3 plus I2, we'll equate to 0, and we'll get the value as we will solve this network, and what equation we'll get, that is nothing but I3 is equal to 2 by 5 into I1 minus 2 by 5 into I2. Correct? Yes. So we will combine. We'll combine these and we'll get the value for V1 and V2. How? Let us see. We obtain total three equations. This is for V1, which is for this one. Then we obtain V2, this is for output port. Then we have obtained third equation, that is for the middle loop. Correct? Now we need to substitute this equation C, because it is consist of which parameter? I3. So we'll put this value. I3 is present over here also, and it is present over here also. So if we simply put the values of V1 and V2, just put it and let me know whether you obtained this equation or not. Okay, simply put this value and let me know whether you obtained the same equation or not.
Yes.
How often this value?
Yes.
Yes. When you put the value in the, for V1 and V2, definitely we will obtain the equation that is 3I1 minus 2 into 2 by 5 into I1 minus 2 by 5 into I2. So if you rearrange the equation, we will get the value of V1. As this one, that is nothing but equation B. And same, we will put the value for V2, we will get the equation E, correct? And when we compare this equation B and E, so just remember the our Z parameter. So Z parameter was V1 and V2 was our dependent variable, and I1 and I2 was our independent variable. So the value we, what we are obtained so far, these are nothing but your value of that particular matrix, correct? So that's why Z11, Z12, Z21, Z22, we will represent it by this equation. Okay. This is a very easy step to obtain the value of Z parameter. Okay. In same way, in similar way, we will look for remaining parameter. Okay. Just have a look. We will discuss all these remaining three. Just have a look on Z parameter. So we'll look for, we'll move for the next one, that is admittance parameter. So simply I'll tell you what we have done. First we have found out the set of parameters for the given electrical network. Correct. We write the equation, we wrote the equation of two port network in terms of desired parameter. We wrote the equation for two port network in terms of Z parameter. We rearrange the equation in such a way that they should similar to the equation of A and B. And by equating the similar equation, we obtain the two equation, that is equation B and E, and you will represent the parameter in matrix form, and we got the value of Z11, Z12, Z21, Z22. Correct. Now same procedure or same steps we will follow for remaining three parameters. Okay. So let us move for next one. That is nothing but U1 Y parameter. Okay. Here there is a slight difference we are using on the form, correct? See, what will the finding in Y parameter? Okay, yes, let me know. In Y parameter, which procedure we follow for the open circuit or short circuit? Which one? Y parameter, it's open circuit or short circuit one? It will be the open circuit or short circuit one for the Y. Yes. Of course. For Y parameter, we will obtain which one? Short circuit.
और जेड पैरामीटर वी ऑप्टेन ओपन सर्किट, सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज शॉर्ट सर्किट पैरामीटर एंड हियर इट इज कॉल्ड एज ओपन सर्किट पैरामीटर, करेक्ट। यस, so let us start for the next one, that is nothing but your with the finding for y parameter. See, whatever the steps that we have followed for z parameter, in continuation with that we'll move further. In continuation with that we'll move further for finding of y parameter. Correct. So what will the steps? So we have obtained the matrix. Yes. I hope I am audible to all of you. If we have obtained the matrix as 11 by 5, 4 by 5, 4 by 5, 6 by 5, correct? We will continue with the same and we will write the equation, we will rewrite the equation in terms of Cramer's rule, for the Cramer's rule. So in admittance parameter, the equation we will rewrite as V1, V2. So this is what, nothing but this one. V1, V2 is equal to matrix into I1 and I2, correct? Now what we need to find out? We need to find out the value for I1, I2. This is what we need to find out. So how we will calculate the value of I1 and I2? Correct? This is a multiplication one and equal we are having voltage. Correct? So for that we'll take help of Cramer's rule. Correct? For that we'll take help of Cramer's rule and we will able to find out the value of I1 and I2. Okay, because the rest of the part we are already covered in finding the Z parameter. Okay, so that's why we are learning all these parameters at a single glance. So you will able to answer of any question if you ask in exam. Correct. So the Cramer's rule is what? Cramer's rule is what? Let us understand. If we consider V1, okay, first we will consider this in the denominator. Correct. And we will replace this column by V1 and V2. Correct. In next case, we'll consider denominator as it is. Only we'll replace this column by V1 and V2. Okay. And we will obtain the values for I1 and I2. And we'll compare this equation. We'll get admittance. Why? Admittance and impedance are the inversely proportional. Correct. So that's why we just need to take replica of it, reciprocal of it, and for this mathematical equation we need to apply the Cramer's rule. Correct. That's it. Now let us put this value for V1, V2, that is for which replace by 11, replace 11 by 5 and 4 by 5. So the equation for the I1 will like this one. We'll simply do the mathematical calculation, that cross product of these two, 6 by 5 into V1 minus 4 by 5 into V2 upon same 11 by 5 into 6 by 5 minus 16 by 5, sorry, 4 by 5 into 4 by 5. Okay, so we'll get the values of these as, that is not, it will not be total value. Why? Because our variables are present over here. So we'll get a value in terms of equation. Okay, so the I1 is nothing but what we obtain equation for I1 is nothing but T by 5 into V1 minus 2 by 5 into V2. Okay, so now this is your task. Obtain the equation for I2 and let it check parallelly whether it is equivalent to G or not. You have 2 minutes. Calculate the equation, put the value of V1, replace the value of V1 and V2, and calculate the answer. And just check whether it is, you obtain the equation G. You have to obtain the equation G. Yes. Make it correct. Within 2 minutes. Yes, kindly let me know the value. You obtain the same value. Yes. What you need to put? You need to put the value of V1. You need to replace by V1 and V2, and you need to obtain the value for I2. So what will the I2 equation? That's what you need to find out. Put the values and let me know. So if you put the values of V1 and V2, you will obtain the values of current I2. So that equation becomes as, the equation come as, again it will be an equation form. Why? Why? Because whatever the value of I1 and I2 we have obtained, it is in variable form, that is V1 and V2. Okay, so we got the equation for I1 and I2, that like F and G, and if we just compare it with the standard one, so whatever the value we have obtained, that is 3 by 5 minus 2 by 5 minus 2 by 5 and 11 by 10, these are nothing but your admittance matrix, correct? So we'll simply put this value and the matrix what we are obtain is nothing but your admittance matrix. Correct? Correct? So this is what we have done. We all follow the same steps. We wrote the equation for two-port network in terms of desired parameter. Then we wrote the equation for two-port network in terms of given parameter. We just rearrange the equations in such a way that we should obtain the similar type of equations, and by equating the similar equation with above, we get the desired parameter in terms of y parameter. Okay, in previous session we have obtained the parameter for Z, that is impedance parameter. Correct? Now, the next one is nothing but your which parameter? Next one is nothing but your which parameter? That is your H parameter. So H parameter, we look for the H parameter. Now same steps, we'll move for the same steps, that is nothing but what we obtain the equation for D and E. So we obtain the equation for D and E here. So with the help of this equation D and E, you will able to calculate the value for this. Correct? Yes. Now we will take help of this equation and we will obtain the value for H parameter. So what will the H parameter? H parameter is the hybrid one where we combine the voltage and current, that is one from the open port and another will be from the short circuit one. Correct? On the combination of these, you will get the values as hybrid parameter. Okay. Now just look into it and try to solve the example. How it would be? Correct? How it would be your value for this? So H parameter, we will write the equation for V2 and you will get the value equation. If you put this value, for I2, so I2 will be what? Minus 2 by 3 into I1 plus 5 by 6 into V2. This is what we have obtained from the equation. We have just rewrite the equation E. Which is equation E? That is this one. What we have to rewrite it for? I2. Correct? We have to rewrite it for I2. In same way, we have to rewrite this equation for equation D. Correct? So, this is nothing but what? What we have obtained? The equation we need to rewrite is for I1. We need to rewrite it for I2, and whatever the equation we'll get, that we need to compare with the our standard parameter. So that is nothing, that will be your hybrid parameter. Okay. So let's see what we have done. See, this is my I2, which is my equation V2. This is my V2 equation. I will take it here. V2. Correct? So I will arrange this equation. I will arrange this equation for I2. So I2 will be what? V2 minus 4 by 5 into I1. V2 minus 4 by 5 into I1. The 6 by 5 will come on the RHS as 5 by 6. And you will get the value as I2 is equal to 5 by 6 into V2 minus 4 by 5 into I1. We will rearrange this term. And you will get the value for 4 by 6 I1 minus 4 by 6 I1 plus 5 by 6 I2, which is minus 2 by 3 I1 plus 5 by 6 I V2. So by substituting this equation F in equation D, what the equation we obtain? We obtain the equation for I2. And if you just look into the equation of V1, so that is nothing but 11 by 5 I1 plus 4 by 5 into I2. So we'll put the value of I2. Just let me know whether you obtain the equation G or not. Correct? Just let me know whether you obtain the equation G or not. You have to follow the same procedure that what we have followed so far. Correct? And you should obtain the equation for this. Correct. So we will put this value of V1 and we will get the equation as, what kind of equation we will get? 5 by 3 into I1 plus 2 by 3 into V2. So this equation we will utilize it for comparing. Now what we will do? We will compare this equation F and equation G. Why we are mixing this all this? Because the hybrid parameter is nothing but it's a combination of z and y, admittance parameter. Correct. So that's why we are mixing all these things, and we will rewrite this equation by comparing equation F and G. So we'll obtain the H parameter. So H matrix will look like as, it will be look like as, I'll just scroll it out. Yeah. So this value will obtain as a H parameter. So H parameter is V1 into H11 into I1, H12 into I2, H12 into V2, and second equation will be for the current. Second equation will it will be for the current, and it will come as I2 is equal to H21 into I1 and H22 into V2. So this is how we get the hybrid equation for, this is how we get the hybrid equation for in terms of voltage and current. Now the last one, that is nothing but your last one, that is nothing but your which one? We have to obtain the equation in terms of ABCD parameter. Correct. So for the ABCD parameter, your equation, will obtain the equation for the ABCD parameter. Same equation we will utilize that what we have obtained for the Z parameter. Correct. D and E equation. Same equation we will utilize that what we have obtained for D and H. So for H parameter, for the equations are D and E, we will rewrite in same way. We will rewrite the equation E. We will rewrite this equation E. Now here we will rewrite it for I1. We will rewrite this equation for I1 and let us check what we obtain. Yes. So what do you obtain? If you rewrite the equation, so equation will come as इक्वेशन विल कम एज I1 इज इक्वल टू 5 बाई 4 V2 माइनस 6 बाई 5 इंटू I2 5 बाई 4 इंटू V2 माइनस 6 बाई 4 इंटू I2 एंड द फाइनल इक्वेशन विल ऑब्टेन फॉर द I1 इज 5 बाई 4 इंटू V2 करेक्ट विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस इक्वेशन विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस इक्वेशन एंड वी विल ऑब्टेन द वैल्यू फॉर V1 सो We'll obtain the value for V1 as 11 by 5, as 11 by 5. So which equation? Equation D. Okay. So the base of this is all remains same. Only we need to modify the equation. So V1 by 5. Yes. Just do the calculation and let me know how you obtain this value for G. That is equation G. Within 2 minutes, you can obtain the value. And let me know whether you obtain the same value or not. What we need to do, we simply put the value of I1 in equation V1 and we will get the value for I1. We will compare the same value with again equation F and we will get the parameter of ABCD. Correct? Correct? We will get the parameter for ABCD. Okay, just note down this parameter of equation, that is V1 is equal to A into V2 minus what? Two more minutes and just give me after whether you obtained it or not. So V1 will obtain as A into V2 minus B into I2 and I1 we will obtain as C into V2, and next will be I1 is equal to C into V2 minus D into I2. We get the parameter. If you compare this one, we will get the parameter of ABCD. So A is equal to 11 by 4, B is equal to 5 by 2, C is equal to 5 by 4, and D is equal to 3 by 2. Correct? Just look into the steps what we have obtained so far. So we have calculated all the parameter in one single network by using which law? KVL. Okay, you obtain the equation by using which law? KVL. Kirchhoff's voltage law we applied to this particular network and we obtain the values. Correct? Just compare all these matrices, that is Z, admittance, hybrid, and ABCD. Okay. And you will get to know the how we represent the two port network in terms of all parameter. So what does the example tells us? The example describes how we obtain the values of two port network in terms of all the parameter. Correct? Yes, now yes, so we have done same the things, we have done same things, we just follow the different steps. For all these parameter calculation, we wrote equation of two port network in terms of desired parameter. We wrote the equation for two port network in terms of all this combination, and we rearrange the equation and we obtain the similar types of equation in the next step. And by equating all these similar equation, we obtain this Z parameter, we obtain this admittance parameter, we obtain hybrid, and we obtain the ABC. So what we have done for the single network, we have find out all the parameter, that is Z, Y, H, and ABCD. Okay, all the parameter we obtained for the single network. Now, for the next network, same network I have considered here, like this one, and I'm using KCL. For this, I'm using KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, to calculate this one. Okay, let us check how we obtain this value for this and what will the things that we will come to know. Yes, so what will the next step? Just listen only. For Z, now we will use the Cramer's rule. Same, we will obtain the admittance for all these things, and accordingly we will obtain the value of H parameter and ABCD parameter. Only the thing is, here we have calculated all the steps in terms of KCL instead of KVL. Correct? That is the main significance difference. That's it. Apart from that, we don't need to do anything else. Only we need to focus on KCL law. Correct? And in next scenario, we will come across this one, that we will calculate other parameter by considering, we will calculate the Z parameter in terms of which one? In terms of admittance, in terms of hybrid, and in terms of ABCD parameter. And accordingly, we will look up for different scenario. Correct? Yes or no? Yes. So, today we just look for, today we just look for which one? Yes. So in next session we'll come across. Hybrid one, then ABCD will add your transmission parameter in terms of your Z admittance and hybrid. And about to that, I think yes, hybrid parameter in terms of Z. So we are making just permutation combination of all these things. That's it. Correct? Yes. So this is what we have looked for today's session, that is two port network for the network and the network function will come quick later. Okay. Yes. So I will stop this recording now.